right, and we're live. All right, shalom, shalom, shalom. This is your brother, Tribe of Judah Awakens 144, back again with another breakdown lesson today. And first off, I want to give praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. I want to say shalom to the scattered elect, scattered across the four winds, and shalom to the apostles and elders who I've been learning off of and taught me this truth in all sincerity. Started with the man of the Lord, Great Millstone, GMS. To you brothers, I say shalom. So, as you guys probably know and can see here on the screen, this is a picture of the missiles fired back on the 12th of May with Israel and Palestine. And they've been going back and forth and having what looks to be a conflict more over 10 days now. And I chose to speak on this, not because I didn't want to, but because mostly, you know, you have a lot of people that already spoke on it, but I just kind of wanted to put my two cents in and to go into prophecy, because we're starting to see what the scriptures have been telling us all along, for those of you who have ears to hear, eyes to see through the Spirit. And we know through the Spirit that these, you know, got to be very careful how I choose my words, because I don't want this video to be a strike and taken down. But prophecy told us what would happen to the nation of Israel pertaining to them going back into their land, and how when they would return back to the land, how things were going to be in the land and how the world was going to be. So, you know, without me having to waste any time, I've already prepared a lesson for you guys to go into some scripture just to say what prophecy is. Because, I mean, look at this, man. Like, we got to understand Israel was set up as a state in 1948. All right. And it became a state. And little do we know that when it became a state, that same exact night that they became a state in the year 1948, Egypt, along with other surrounding countries, ended up dropping bombs on Israel the same evening they declared themselves a state. All right. Because the everybody else around knows that, you know, they know who should be in the land and who should not be in the land. I'll just leave it at that. All right. So, this is the article on RT News, which says Israel, Hamas agree on Gaza ceasefire proposed by Egypt to end 11-day conflict. So again, as I said, you know, people look at it as, well, hey, they've been doing this from centuries and all of this, and it really hasn't been that long, because how long has you know, the Israelites been out of their land? They've been scattered across the four corners of the earth, according to prophecy. But also the prophecy states that the Most High Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shah, through his son Yahweh Shah, was going to be the redeemer to bring Israel back into the land. All right. And let's get that. So we're going to get Isaiah, the second chapter. We'll start at verse 1. The Most High's universal reign. It says, the word that Isaiah, the son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. Okay, so once again, like I always say in my videos, Judah was known as the southern nation. So you had Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. Okay, they consist of the southern nation. Jerusalem were the other 10 tribes. Okay, so it would be sometimes called Ephraim or Manasseh or Joseph. Okay, now, verse 2, it says, and it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall follow unto it. Now, mountains goes into, that's a symbolic way of saying governor, a governor body, right? Hills, a smaller a hierarchy, but mountains is known as that government body, that structure, right? Verse 3. And many people shall go and say, come ye and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. And he will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion, shall go forth the law, Which again, hey, there it is again. There's proof right there. This is an end time prophecy, The laws was never done away with. So Christianity, I mean, y'all got to explain this scripture here. If the laws were done away with, why is it saying that the nations are going to come up and learn the way of the Heavenly Father? Because out of Zion, Zion is a people before it's a place. It's talking about all of Israel shall go forth the law, And the word of the Lord Yahweh from Jerusalem. Verse 4. Here's the point. And he shall judge among the nations, And shall rebuke many people, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. So just like how our ancestors in the transatlantic slave trade, we had to, the pruning hooks, we was, shoveling that hay, clearing off the railroads, picking the cottons and all that stuff. You heathen nations, y'all gonna get busy when we get in the kingdom. It says, nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. So when the children of Israel were going to be placed back into their land, the prophecy says that nation should not lift up sword against nation. Neither shall they learn war anymore. But what we've been seeing is missiles. What did they say? Something to the effect that they dropped like on that day. They combated like dropped something to the effect to the Salaki, the effect of 1,000 missiles or something like that, like 1,000 to 1,200 missiles or something like that, man. So one would have to ask, with the people being in the land, is not really, matching up with prophecy, because when the true people return back into their land, when the Israelites go back into their land, Isaiah 2 and 4, when the nations were going to be judged, nations shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. So now we have to ask the question, if we're following prophecy, Because this is the problem. People don't want to deal with prophecy. But if we were to follow prophecy, we have to, one will have to ask, are the people in that land really are the children of Israel? We know the truth, But I'm just saying this to, for the sake to be saying it. Now, if we get a precept to that, peaceful latter days, This is another precept to Isaiah 2 and 4, This is Micah chapter 4. We're going to start at verse 1. But in the last days, it shall come to pass that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established in the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and the people shall flow unto it, We just read that in Isaiah 2. Verse 2, and many nations shall come and say, come and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord and to the house of the God of Jacob, and we will teach, he will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For the law shall go forth of Zion in the word of the Lord Yahweh from Jerusalem. Verse 3, and he shall judge among many people and rebuke strong nations afar off. Why is he going to rebuke them? Because when he dispersed Judah and Jerusalem, he separated the sons of the living power to the sons of men and to the sons of the wicked. See, the Bible describes man three different ways. You have the sons of the living power, which is Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, which is Israel. You have the sons of men, which are the heathen nations. And then you have the sons of the wicked, which is Esau, Edom. It says here, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up a sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. This is end time prophecy. So this is already showing us that the people that are in the land, that they're over there fighting, it's not, they're not adding up with prophecy. And again, I'm trying to choose my words carefully because I don't want this video to get taken down. But for the sake of this video, what's going on over there in that land is not matching with prophecy when it comes to the true native people, So let's close these out. Let's go to Ezekiel, the 37th chapter, which is another end time prophecy. And let's see how all of this ties in together. Let's see how the children of Israel were meant to come back to the land during the latter days. This is Ezekiel 37 and 21. And it reads, and say unto them, thus said the Lord thy power, Yahweh is his name. Behold, I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen, whither they be gone, and will gather them on every side and bring them into their own land. Okay, what does he mean by every side? Again, going back, Israel were scattered among the heathen. They were scattered among the four corners of the earth. And Lord willing, we're going to get that scripture. But what the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, is saying is that in the latter days, he's going to take the children of Israel. He's going to gather all of us where he scattered us, and he's going to put us back in our rightful land, right? Verse 22, and I will make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king to them all. We already know who that king is. It's Yahweh Shai, okay? Right through King David and the 144, 12,000 out of each tribe, which is going to be the governing body. They're going to be the rightful heirs under Yahweh Shai, okay? And they shall be no more two nations, okay? Because remember I said Jacob was the southern kingdom. Israel was the 10 tribes, was the northern kingdom. As of right now, we're still split. The last time we were known as one nation is under the King Solomon's rule. And that only lasted for 40 years. So now both kingdoms have been split. Okay, but watch what it says here. I'll read it over from the top. And I will make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king to them all. And they shall be no more two nations, neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms anymore at all. Okay, because again, Jacob and Israel, the kingdoms are split. Verse 23, neither shall they defile themselves anymore with their idols, nor with their detestable things, nor with any of their transgressions, but I will save them out of all their dwelling places wherein they have sinned, and will cleanse them. So shall they be my people, and I will be their power. Okay? Because you got to ask yourself, I said earlier that Israel was established as a state in the year 1948. You guys can look this up. So you have to explain to me, okay, if that's the case, where is King David? Where is Yahweh Shai? Because if the people are claiming to be the people over there in the land, then we have to go according to prophecy. All right, so let's get Isaiah, the 11th chapter, starting at the 11th verse, and it says, and it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time. Why? Because the first time he led us out of Egypt under the Pharaoh, right? That was known as the Great Exodus, right? The Passover, right? But the second time, he's going to set his hand a second time to recover the remnant of his people. Now, when you go into this word remnant, all right, let's look it up real quick.
Strong's H 7605. She'ar.
Right? And it says here rest, residue, remnant, remainder, right? A remainder, other, remnant, residue, rest. Now, why is he only going to get the remainder of all the 12 tribes? Because according to Jeremiah, the 30th chapter, right around the 7th verse, due to Jacob's trouble, okay, and according to Zechariah, the 13th chapter, right, only one third is going to be put through the fire, meaning they're going to be put through while the pestilence is going on, the famine, okay, the sword being implemented through the Heavenly Father's indignation, okay, only one third, a remnant, who was out there doing the work, have the faith, okay, keeping the commandments to the best of their ability. Only those who were written in the book of life are going to make it. The rest of the two-thirds of Israel is going to be put to death on this side. But according to Romans, the 11th chapter, 26th verse, all Israel shall be saved, okay? But only a remnant on this side is going to be saved, all right? So going back, just to get that out the way, right? It says here, the remnant of his people, which shall be left from Assyria and from Egypt and from Pathros and from Cush and from Elam and from Shinar and from Hamath and from the islands of the sea. So all the islands of the sea, this is where all both two kingdoms Southern kingdom and northern kingdom were scattered. Okay. Verse 12, and he shall set up an ensign for the nations and shall assemble the outcasts of Israel. Okay. And gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth, north, south, east, west. That's what it's talking about. Okay. Four corners of the earth. Verse 13, the envy also of Ephraim shall depart, and the adversaries of Judah shall be cut off. Ephraim shall not envy Judah, and Judah shall not vex Ephraim, which means Judah being a southern kingdom, Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Ephraim being the other 10 tribes. We're going to come together. We're going to put our differences aside, and we're going to come together. All right? Now, let's get that out the way. This is Jeremiah 16 and 15. But the Lord Yahweh liveth that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north, okay, Babylon the Great, and from all the lands whither he had driven them. Why? Because according to Deuteronomy 28:68, we were not going to see our land again. We was going to be put back into Egypt. Egypt is symbolic, is known as the house of bondage, slavery again. Okay? We were going to be scattered. When you go up a few verses, I think around verse 64, it says that we were going to be scattered. We was going to be given to the hands of our enemies, of a nation whose tongue we would not know, right? So now, though, when you go into the prophecies, we know that the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans makes up the curses that was put on. This is how we know who the true children of Israel are, okay? And I don't give a damn if you want to disagree or whatever like that, man. You just got to follow the prophecies. Because you take a look at the nation today, and all you have to do is look at the nation of people who fit them damn curses. And we know without a shadow of a doubt that the people that are over there in the land today of Israel do not fit those curses. I'll leave it at that. We'll read verse 15 again from the top. But the Lord Yahweh liveth that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north and from all the lands whither he had driven them, and I will bring them again into their land that I gave unto their fathers. Okay, because did not Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah tell Abraham, okay, I was going to bless your seed and they was going to inherit the land, which back then was known as Canaan, okay, which today now is called Israel. You understand that? Verse 16, behold, I will send for many fishers, said the Lord, and they shall fish them. And after will I send for many hunters, and they shall hunt them from every mountain and from every hill, which represents the governments, these other nations, and out of the holes of the rocks. For my eyes are upon all their ways. They are not hid from my face, neither is their iniquity hid from my eyes. Okay? Because he's going to give a recompense to these other nations. When you get the book of Joel, the third chapter, the book of Revelation, the 18th chapter, Second Esdras and the Apocrypha, the 13th chapter, talks about Yahawashah. Okay? Esdras having that vision, saw Yahawashah come up from the midst of the sea. And then Second Esdras 15 and the 16 chapters. Okay, goes into World War III, known in the book as Armageddon, that final judgment, Yahweh Shaphat, Jehoshaphat, the valley. All right, that's what it's talking about. Now, it says here, 18, and first I will recompense their iniquity and their sin double, because they have defiled my land, they have filled my inheritance with the carcasses of the detestable and abominable things. Okay, O Lord, my strength and my fortress and my refuge in the day of affliction, the Gentiles shall come up. Shalakia, the Gentiles shall come unto thee from the ends of the earth and shall say, surely our fathers have inherited lies, vanity, and things wherein there is no profit. So these people here think that they're the people. When the scripture says that our fathers, let me read it again. The Gentiles shall come up to the ends from the earth, because the Gentiles are the other nations, people. That's what it's talking about. Okay. And shall say, surely our fathers have inherited lies. Why? Because they've been told that they were the people. They're not the people. And that's what's happening now. That's why the spirit has come down and has awakened us to realize that we've been asleep all this time. We're the only nation of people who don't know who we are. We don't have a history or where we go back to. We are not African Americans. All right? Let's keep it moving, right? We got more. Jeremiah, the 23rd chapter, verse 3. And I will gather the remnant. They go that word again, okay? Only the remainder of Israel, who are written in the book of life, of my flock out of all countries, all countries, not singular, plural, whither I have driven them and will bring them again to their folds, and they shall be fruitful and increase. Okay? Now, I just done a video, Salakia, which I'm uploading on, yes, in the kingdom we will have multiple wives. Okay? We got to be fruitful and increase. We're not going to increase just off of having wives. We're going to be blessed. Okay? Isaiah 60 and 22 says that a small one should become 1,000. How is that small one going to become 1,000? He's not going to have one woman, I can guarantee you that. But you can go, you guys can go watch that video. I broke it down. Verse 4, and I will set up shepherds over them which shall feed them, and they shall fear no more, nor be dismayed, neither shall they be lacking, said the Lord Yahweh. You understand that? Then it goes in. How's he going to do that? Watch this. Verse 5. Behold, the days come, said the Lord Yahweh, that I will raise unto David a righteous branch, and a king shall reign and prosper and shall execute judgment and justice in the earth. We know that was in King Solomon, because even though King Solomon reigned for 40 years, okay, and he walked, but he still went off. He sinned, okay? Watch this, verse 6, here's the point. In his days, Judah shall be saved. You see that? Judah shall be saved and Israel shall dwell safely. Judah and Israel are still split today. So we know that this must be an end time prophecy because Judah and Israel are not dwelling safely. There's your proof right here. May 12, 2021. This is your proof. If Judah and all of Israel return back to the land in 1948, we have a problem because according to prophecy, in his days, when the Messiah, that righteous branch, that king, Judah shall be saved and Israel shall dwell safely. And this is his name whereby he shall be called the Lord our righteousness. And we all know that to be Yahweh Shah. But let's keep it moving. Jeremiah 30th chapter. All right. Verse 3. For lo, the days come, said the Lord, that I will bring again the captivity of my people Israel and Judah. When it says again, he's talking about he's going to recover. Because Judah and Israel are still in captivity today. That's why I said in order to understand who the true people are, you have to go by the curses. Which nation of people on the planet Earth today fit those curses? Okay? Go and read Deuteronomy 28, verses 15 all the way down to 68, and make a comparison, cross-reference to see which nation of people fit those curses. Said the Lord, and I will cause them to return to the land that I gave to their fathers, and they shall possess it. Okay? He's going to cause us to come up there. He's going to save us. All right? Let's keep it moving. Finish it up. All right? Now, if we scroll down here, it's still the same chapter. Jeremiah 30, verse 10. Therefore, fear thou not, O my servant Jacob, said the Lord, neither be dismayed, O Israel, for lo, I will save thee from afar and thy seed from the land of their captivity. And Jacob shall return and shall be in rest and be quiet, and none shall make him afraid. Once again, we have here a contradiction to what's actually happening right now compared to prophecy. Because, as I said, if the nation of people that are over there right now in the land are who they claim to be, Jacob shall be at rest and quiet, and none shall make him afraid. But what do we see going on here? So, somebody lying. Okay, I'm gonna leave it at that. I can't say too much on it, right? Verse 11, for I am with thee, said the Lord Yahweh, to save thee. Though I make a full end of all nations, whether I have scattered thee, okay, yet will I not make a full end of thee, but I will correct thee in measure and will not leave thee altogether unpunished. So basically, what he's saying is, if we get, let me do this for y'all real quick. Break it down to y'all so y'all can understand what he's talking about. Because basically what he's going into, if we get the Apocrypha, all right, Because even though he scattered us, right, he still kept us fed, preserved until the latter times, all right? Because he was going to judge the nations for what they did unto us. That gets Baruch. Yep, this is Baruch chapter 4, and we'll start at verse 4. O Israel, happy are we, for things that are pleasing to the Most High are made known unto us. Be of good cheer, my people, the memorial of Israel. Ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because you moved the Most High to wrath, ye were delivered unto the enemies. Okay? And I always say, when you want to know who the enemies were, let's get Psalms, the 83rd chapter. Okay? Psalms 83 and 2, we'll start at, for lo, thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. Drop down, verse 4. Actually, we'll read verse 3. We'll just read on down. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. Verse 5, for they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. The tabernacles of, tells you who are our enemies, Edom, the Ishmaelites, Moab, and the Hagarenes, Gabal, Ammon, Amalek. Okay, these nations are enemies of us. That's what it's talking about. So going back, we were sold to the nations because we broke the covenant. That's how we moved the Most High to wrath. We broke the first covenant. All right. Matthew 1. What's the end time prophecy? Well, we know that Yahweh Shah came on the scene, and it says here, Matthew 1 and 21, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Yahweh Shah, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now, if we jump to Luke 1, starting at verse 68, it says, blessed be the Lord, thy power of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people, and hath raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us, to perform the mercy promised to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant. Because what? We get Hebrews, the 8th chapter. Okay. New covenant. Let's start at verse 8. For finding fault with them, he said, behold, the days come, said the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Showing you that the Most High from the Old Testament to the New Testament was only dealing with the nation of Israel. Okay, so these other nations, these other heathen nations, they have no part in the new covenant at all. So we know, judging for the mess that's going on, okay, it's Lakia. Judging from the mess that's going on in Israel right now over there in that land, okay, we have to pay attention to prophecy. So, you know, I didn't want this to be too long, but Lord willing, you guys were edified. But when you start to, the scripture says, study to show thyself approved. So when you start to read your scriptures, gain a proper understanding of the breakdowns, and, you know, read the prophecies and gain a true understanding of the prophecies, you can start to put two and two together. So hopefully you guys were edified. This is Band Tribe of Judah Awakens 144 over and out.